Hey kid, do you wanna have fun?
Yeah!
All you need is Willy, the little engine that pumps. You can make its wheel turn.
Fantastic.
Watch the divider go up and down.
So much fun.
But most importantly, you can turn heat energy into mechanical work.
Science!
Willy, the little engine that pumps. Rainbows not included.
Hello there. How are you doing today?
I hope you are doing well.
I'm Nemo, and today in Curiosity we are going to talk about one of my favorite objects ever so far, which is the Stirling engine.
Here you go.
I find this object fascinating for two reasons. The first one is that it's just beautiful, it's visually appealing, and I feel like you can put it anywhere you want, it will just always look good. It really has this steampunk vibe that I'm really into. The other reason is that in Curiosity I am planning to talk about the science behind curious objects. But sometimes, well, that science is not really apparent and you have to dig for it. But here, it's just pure science. For me, it's just a mix of science, engineering, education, and design in one small desk toy, and this is why I love it. Let me boil some water, and I'll be back to you.
Ooh, here we go, that's hot.
The Stirling engine is a heat engine. What it does is that it turns heat energy into mechanical work through cyclic compression and expansion of a working fluid. In our case, it's air, and it's inside the cylinder. Let me put it on top of my hot mug, and while we wait, I'm gonna explain to you how it works. So the Stirling engine is divided in few parts. You have a cylinder that is containing the air. It has two metallic plates, one on the bottom and one on top. This part is attached to another cylinder containing a power piston. The piston is free to move up and down. As you know, when you heat a gas that is not contained inside rigid walls, it will expand. Here, our main cylinder is rigid, but the piston, being free to move, will go up when the gas is heated and go down when it's cooled. The piston is connected to a wheel through a connecting rod. So now we need to find a way to create a cycle to heat and cool the working fluid, which is air, in the cylinder in our case. The brilliant idea here is to connect the wheel to a loose-fitting displacer that I actually called divider in the embarrassing intro. The displacer function is to move the air within the cylinder to be in contact with the top or the bottom plate. You can, for example, heat the bottom plate and leave the top plate at room temperature, like what I'm doing right now. It is important that the points where the rods are connected to the wheels are 90 degrees out of phase, so to give time to the gas to expand or contract. So the air in the cylinder is heated, the piston goes up, the wheel turns, the displacer goes down, and then the air is cooled, the piston goes down, the wheel turns and the displacer goes up, the air is heated, etc, etc. Now let's see if it is working. Sometimes it needs a little help. It's working. It's pretty slow, but it's working. Let me show you closer. It's very squeaky. I find this fascinating because, well, there's just no batteries. The heat from my mug that is just making the wheel turn. So now I have a question for you. What do you think will happen if I put the Stirling engine on ice? Answer A. Nothing will happen. B. It will turn in the same direction as right now. C. It's going to turn in the opposite direction. And answer D. I don't really care. You can't say it. It's not like I'm offended or anything. Well, leave a comment below. I'm curious to know what you predicted. I prepared some ice. This guy is very hot. Ooh, hot. Maybe it's not a good idea. Maybe we should wait a little bit. Okay, now it should be fine. Let's put it here and let's wait. An interesting fact about the Stirling engine is that it was created in 1816 by Robert Stirling. It is supposed that his goal was to create a safer alternative to steam engines, which boilers had a tendency to explode. So this is where my microphone dies. I'm gonna comment in post. I tried to make the wheel turn in the same direction as before and it doesn't work. I'm gonna try to turn it in the opposite direction. And it seems to work, but I need to push a little bit more. And here you go. It is turning, but it's turning in the opposite direction. So the right answer was answer C. What's interesting is, from what I understand, the engine works with a difference in temperature of around 20 Kelvin or 20 degrees Celsius. If it's cold enough outside, it should be able to work just putting it on top of your hand. That was the Stirling engine. I hope you liked it, and I'll see you next time for another curiosity. I want to thank all my patrons from Patreon, Tentacle Duck, Downtown, Anita, and Yves-Marie, and also everybody else who has been buying t-shirts and merchandise on my shops. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't be afraid to share and subscribe, and I'll see you very soon.